In this guide, I'll be showing you how to easily start creating mind-blowing images on Leonardo AI. If you do not know Leonardo, it's gotta be the best image generator out there as far as my research goes, with some amazing features. These images can be used in videos, presentations, marketing documentation, books, and any material you can imagine. And the good thing is, you have the copyright, since you've generated them on AI. I've been using Leonardo for my other YouTube channels, and it's been providing me some amazing images for my shorts. This will be a straightforward guide and will contain the most important toolbox. Starting by the basics, knowing the different engines or fine-tuned models and what you can get from them, how to use prompts properly, how you can upscale images and remove backgrounds, how to create series of similar images, very useful when creating an avatar, for example, how you can animate images, and finally, free version or paid subscription. Let's get into it. So, the app is rather intuitive. The prompt, or description of the desired image, goes in here. Over here you have the different engines. They call them fine-tuned models. We'll get back to them in a second. Here it tells you how much it will cost to generate. And over here on the left, the settings for your image. Number of images for each prompt. I usually go for 4 images at a time, and sometimes more. The more you choose, the more it will cost in coins. Then you have the photo real mode button. Also extra cost if you activate it. Then you have the alchemy mode button, which comes at an extra cost. As you'll see, this mode is very important for quality images. And down here you have the scale and resolution of the image. The bigger resolution, the more it will cost. So to show you the engines, I'm gonna take the same prompt and show you the result. For better neutrality, I inspire my prompt from the Leonardo persona. So, full portrait of a mystical and mysterious ancient grown man with a white beard, posing very colorful, serious expression, bold lines, Willy Wonka attire, and generate. I'm gonna make it simple. You have 3 categories of generations. First, the photo realistic. You can see the results. I mean, it's crazy. You can hardly tell the difference with a real professional photo. Oh, and do you remember the alchemy mode we talked about? Those were with alchemy on. And here it is, with alchemy off. Good, but not as good. Then, you have the cartoon or anime style engine. It's called 3D animation style. It's actually one of my favorites. Here is the generation without alchemy. Doesn't look good, right? I tell you, it's really worth the extra coin. So, the 2 I just mentioned are the special ones, in the sense they have their specialty. All the other ones, Vision, Kino, and so on, are, how to put it, very similar. They do have their own style, but it will take some time to note the nuances. After 3 months of using them, I can say my favorite among them is the Albedo Base, a very polyvalent engine. It can create realistic photos, as well as cartoon-like images. All it takes is the right wording in the prompt. And that takes us to our second point. How to master the prompt to get the image you imagine. A simple way to understand it is to look at the prompts of those insane images that are public. For example, I can take this image over here and reuse the prompt, but instead of a cat, I'll ask for a cute little dog, a Labrador. And here are the results. Amazing, isn't it? What's interesting to note is this. Take a look at the prompts of these professional artists. You'll notice that most of them describe the ambience and style of the image, rather than the objects or elements in it. And I guess that is the best tip for prompts. Always limit yourself to art direction in the prompts, not details of the image, and let the AI be creative. Otherwise, you might find yourself with unwanted results. To illustrate this with an example, I was once looking for a classroom with a green board in an anime style. But the word green made the AI only give me green images, although I had only asked for a green board. So remember, art direction, not image details. Moving on to our next tip, upscale and remove backgrounds. So when you create an image, it will have an okay resolution. If you want a better resolution for display, you can go down here and hit the smooth alchemy upscale. It will cost some 5 extra coins, totally worth it. The difference is noticeable. Also, you can remove the background with this little net button. Note that the result can vary depending on the image. It can miss some complex images, but generally it works pretty good. If you plan on using them on CapCut, there is a nice feature to remove the background only on human characters, which also works pretty well. There are other alternatives that are also free, like Adobe Firefly. Moving on to how to create series of images. So, very often, you may want to make an avatar in different positions or environments. If you simply regenerate, you will often obtain different results and different characters. And that's where the image guidance feature comes in handy. To illustrate this, let's say I want this same character, but holding a glass. All you need to do is turn on image guidance, choose the image you want to use as reference for your character, and adapt your prompt. You also have the guidance strength cursor to tell how close you want it to be to your reference image. And here is the result. The same character holding a glass as I asked. Next up, how to animate images. Not animate like this, that's on another app. What Leonardo allows you to do is more a camera movement type of animation. To do that, scroll down to your generation history and click on Image to Motion. It also has a movement strength cursor you can play with. You may have to try it out multiple times before you get what you want. Most times, it will give you camera movement, which can be really cool, depending on the image. But when there is a full body, the AI will try to give you a real animation. More or less glitchy, most of the times, I must say. Some look better than others, but I still prefer the camera movement, as other apps allow for better, real animations. And now, the good stuff. Free version or subscription? Well, first, let's do the math. From my experience, this is how much each image costs. Let's break it down. You want to generate at least 4 images at a time for 2 reasons. It is cheaper by the unit, and you'll be generating multiple times either way before you get the result you expect. So that's 8 coins. Then you want to have alchemy on, because you want great images, right? I guess if you feel the normal mode is enough, good for you. You just saved 12 coins. And let's suppose you'll want to upscale 1 image out of the 4. So that's 25 coins for each image. Back to the different plans. We can quickly see that it comes down to 3 things: number of coins available, speed of generation, and private models training. The free plan gives you 150 coins per day and limits you in speed and model training. The $12 monthly plan gives you 8,500 coins per month and gives you speed and model training. The other plans give you more coins, more speed, and more model training. From my experience, if you plan on using Leonardo on a regular basis for videos, presentations, or books, the free version will not be enough, especially considering the great consumption of coins you'll be facing in real life. For example, making this video took over 5,000 coins. And if you produce content, don't think you'll work your way out with the free version, despite the low generation speed. I have a paid subscription, and some sets of images take up to 60 seconds to generate. That's a lot in the AI world, and it will destroy your productivity. My advice is to go for the $12 plan and see from there. You can upgrade and downgrade the plan anytime, so no rush there. So with this set of tips I shared with you, you'll be all good to start creating insane images. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to share them down below. And as always, don't forget to subscribe for more content. Until next time, cheers.